Hello YouTube, and welcome to another one of my famous map videos. This time I will be covering the Blackwater War, one of the wars fought by the Riemann Empire in the First Era. Since there's not much to go on in terms of locations in this war, except for a few specifics, I have taken some liberties with further virtualizing the war. I think I did pretty well, and please let me know your opinions in the comments below. Now hold on. Before you watch this video, it's very useful for you to watch the video I did on the Riemann Empire. That way you will get a bit of context on the war itself, and it generally gets better understandable. So with that said, let's kick off the video. The Blackwater War was an armed conflict between the rising Riemann Empire, watch my video on them for more explanation, and the different tribes of Argonia. The conflict was initiated with the goal of annexing Argonia into the Riemann Empire as a province of Blackmarsh, and it took 26 years. The war is separated into a few imperial campaigns, three to be precise, and we will touch on all three in this video. So it was the year 2811 of the First Era, and a popular young general called Agurius Bucco had launched an imperial invasion force into Blackmarsh. A few months prior, the imperial legion had already taken a bit of land at the border of Blackmarsh in what is called the Battle of Argonia. It is this battle where Bucco has obtained his general status. Bucco boasted to Riemann Cyrodiil and the Elder Council that he could take the province with ease, and he was then awarded leadership of the 4th Legion to have a try at Blackmarsh. They at first had some considerable successes, swiping through the remaining border regions of Blackmarsh until they reached the swamps. Now, the area I took as swamp in this video, I've ripped off a semi-official map, so I will stick with this map on the swamp. However, the way the story is told in the book on the Blackwater War makes me think that the swamp is much larger in fact, so take my map with a grain of salt. Once the 4th Legion had reached the swamps of Blackmarsh, they fought themselves in quite a nasty situation. As they soon discovered, fighting in swamps is much more different than fighting on solid ground like Cyrodiil. In lore, we learn that the Imperial Legion is nearly undefeatable when able to fight in their formations on solid ground. However, in the swamps, things become a bit harder. The Argonians were expert of fighting in the swamplands, and thus they had a hard time defending themselves against the Argonians. Diseases spread quickly in the damp camps, causing for a large portion of the soldiers to die in the first campaign. Another large factor with the Argonian advantage was that the Imperial armor was quite heavy. I mean, if we take the Skyrim example, you see that there's a lot of metal on it, and that's really heavy to carry around in the swamp. So it rusted due to all the wetness in the air, and a lot of mud always clinged to all the metal. In the end, a lot of soldiers just threw away their armor and fought in their leather outfits, less protected, but at least they could move well. In all the chaos, the swamp made for a huge loss in coordination, and the chain of command was all but lost in the hectic swampland fights, making it easy for the Argonians to just pick off the Imperials one by one. After 5 years, the army had been reduced to only a few small cohorts, and at this moment General Bucco called for the help of the Emperor, and the Emperor granted him the 2nd Legion. But instead of fighting, he ordered the 2nd Legion to make a paved road, called Riemann's Way, through the conquered territory so that the troops could be supplied well through steady supply lines, and regrouping would become easier because they could always regroup on that road. This did not work out the way he wanted it to work out, and the working soldiers were picked off one by one by the Argonians. After 4 years, the road project was given up, and after the almost complete decimation of the 2nd Legion, the legion that built the road, and the 4th Legion was only left with 350 exhausted troops and a few soldiers that had remained from the 2nd Legion. They actually tried mutiny against Bucco, and he survived it and regained command over the army, but he realized how dire the situation was in the war, and he decided to retreat back to the outermost parts of the swamp, giving up all the worthless terrain he had gained during the years of the long campaign. They had reached an ancient city with a large pyramid at the center they had conquered earlier and regrouped there. However, the Argonians besieged the city and annihilated the soldiers once the city had fallen. This, as you might have guessed, caused the Empire to be kind of embarrassed. After all, a large part of the failure was Bukos' poor judgment and decision making. So the Elder Council decided to show strength to the Argonians and relaunched the campaign into the swamp, this time under General Regulus Sardecus, heading a new rebuilt Fourth Legion for the invasion. General Sardecus was in all terms and purposes one of the best generals the Empire had at their disposal. He fought many wars and was a very highly regarded tactician. Sardecus decided to learn from Bukos' mistakes and outfitted his men with light imperial armor, the one made from leather. And he also had some non-hostile Argonians for the occupied territories guide the army into the swamps, consulting them on the field and how to use the jungle to use to their advantage instead of the Argonians' advantage. He deployed a tactic that caused for his soldiers to work in smaller groups this time, so they could operate more efficiently, and that the chain of command wouldn't be lost in case of a cutoff, but that those groups could always communicate internally. He also threw his diplomatic skills into his tactic. He knew there was no Argonian government; these were independent tribes. So he also figured that there were probably some tribes that probably hated each other. He used this to forge alliances with some of the Argonian tribes who felt they were better served as part of the Empire. He managed to triple his forces by using these Argonian tribes. And with their help, he very quickly recovered all Bukos' the lost territory. He also realized that the Argonians' main advantage was knowing how to fight in the swamp. So he thought, what can I do about that? Then he came up with the idea to merely destroy the swamp and make it an equal battlefield for the both of them. He drained the swamps, torched the trees, poisoned the Argonian rice fields, and had his soldiers cut down a lot of trees, which makes for an excellent resource buffer for the legion. This tactic worked really well, and he was on his way to conquer the entire swamp in a really short time. However, he made one mistake. The commander Cyrodiil ordered him to torch a large peat bog swamp around Stormhold in the north, so they could conquer the city. It worked. However, what they did not realize was that underneath the swamp there were tunnels connecting the entire province, and one of these tunnels caught fire. They did not really notice anything was wrong until suddenly, a few months later, large fires started appearing all over the province. The entire province seemed to be on fire due to the many swamp gases coming from and explosions everywhere. A large part of Black Marsh was completely destroyed and completely uninhabitable. The event came to be called the Great Burn and lasted for over 3 years. Eventually, 1 year into the Great Burn event, Sardecus decided to retreat from the province as it had become unconquerable to him, but also uncontrollable for the Argonian enemy forces. However, on his way back from the Imperial City, he was poisoned by an Argonian Shadow Scale agent and he died. This is, however, never confirmed, but this is what is speculated. So another 2 years later, the fire finally had died down, and one of the Sardecus' lieutenants had gained generalship in the meantime, Lucina Falco. She was instructed to invade Black Marsh one final time, and this time make sure you don't torch the entire province. She took Sardecus' strategy and even improved it a bit by contacting mercenary warships and have them work together with the Imperial Navy and have them raid the coastal cities to remove resources for the Argonian army. She made her troops into even smaller groups called Red Belts, all led by minor officers who had fought in the Sardecus campaign. This was extremely effective, and quickly all of Western Black Marsh was taken. They also sweep through the swamps, but quickly, due to the small size of the troops, the Argonians managed to just take back the land. This made the whole conflict into a bloody guerrilla war that had a lot of casualties on both sides. And it endured for 2 years, after which the Argonians abruptly stopped resisting and just went home. Yes, literally, this is how the conflict ended. Everyone just went home. It is speculated that this was due to tribal infighting and the Argonians no longer having the capacity to really fight back. So they unofficially surrendered, and within a year the Empire had claimed all of Black Marsh. So, this was the Blackwater War, as it is called. It is the campaign of the Imperial Riemann Empire versus the Argonian tribes in the late First Era. What do you guys think of the video? Please let me know in the comments below. And while you're at it, after this, I don't know how long it will be until a new lore video from me. But I worked with some people from the Half-Baked Production channel to make a lore video. And actually, they made a lore video and I even appear in it. I voiced some of the lines. So go check out this lore video that I hopefully have put in the eye icon now. And if not, it's in the description because I don't know how eye icons work. So, when you've done all that, if you like the video, like, subscribe, and all those things. And of course, if you want to support me in a more personal way, consider supporting me on Patreon. As a Patreon subscriber, you get a private channel in my Discord, which is also in the description, together with my Instagram. And as a Patreon subscriber, you'll gain access to discarded scripts of videos I never decided to make, some behind the scenes material, and some general posts about life, I suppose. And I have something else in mind for the Patreon, but that will come later. I'm not sure if it will work yet. So, finally, I will see you all in the next lore video.